wonderforest.com.
Okay, students, in this session we are going to study with the naming reactions of the ethers. Okay, it is completely based upon the NCERT, but the NCERT have difficulties in understanding and extracting the information from the NCERT as per our requirement. Okay, so you can make a juice of the NCERT as per the examination and drink it, and you will get the good marks in the board examination as well as entrance examination. Okay, so these topics are selected according to the mains exams, IIT JEE mains exams and NEET exam and advanced as well as board exams. In the board exams there will be naming reaction, define the following. Okay, so according to marking scheme, what are the things you have to highlight? And from where the entrance examination concept starts, that I will clearly segregate and tell you. Okay. So the very famous from the ethers chapter, there are only two reactions which are much and much more important. First thing is Williamson synthesis. And second thing is the reaction of the ether with acid halide. Acid halide means HX. So in that HX also most important is hydrogen iodide. So different condition, different mechanism will be followed and different products are possible. So students are confusing in that. How to identify the product when different cases are given. Okay. So first of all, let's start with the board level examination and I will try to enumerate the topics and questions from where the entrance examination questions are framed. Okay. So first of all, Williamson synthesis. As I told you in everything, first the foremost thing you will identify is what is the reactant, what is the product, what is the reagent. Okay. So here, this is the preparation of the ether. Okay. Williamson synthesis is preparation of ether from using, by using what? Haloalkane. Okay. In present with the sodium alkoxide. Okay, it is an important method for the preparation of both symmetrical ether and unsymmetrical ether. Okay, so what is ether? Already I have told you. So if this is alkyl group and this is alkyl group, if both alkyl group attached on the oxygen are same, then it is called as a symmetrical alkene. Symmetrical ether. If they both are different, one is R and another is R dash, then it is called as a unsymmetrical ether. Okay, so what we are using? We are using the reactant alkyl halide and reagent will be sodium alkoxide. This is the sodium alkoxide and this is the alkyl halide. Alkyl halide when treated with the sodium alkoxide will form the ether. So depending on if these R dash is exactly same as R, then we are going to get the symmetrical ether. Otherwise it will be unsymmetrical ether. Simple, what happens? The X from the haloalkane and sodium from the sodium alkoxide will form the NaX. Okay. Now, then we are going to take the special conditions. Okay. So, first condition is ethers containing substituted alkyl group are secondary or tertiary. Okay. So, ethers containing, suppose this is the ether and this is the substituted. Okay. So if it is CH3 and here also hydrogen, here also hydrogen, it is simple ether. Now if it is substituted with one more methyl group, then it will be secondary ether. If it is attached with one more methyl group, then it is called as a tertiary ether. Okay, may also be prepared by this method, but that reaction involves SN2 attack on the alkoxide or on ion on the primary alkyl halide. Okay. So now let us see what is SN2. S stands for substitution. S stands for what? Substitution. Okay. And N stands for what? Nucleophile. N stands for nucleophile. Okay. And 2 stands for bimolecular. 2 stands for what? Bimolecular. That means 2 molecule will be at a time react with each other. Okay. So SN2, substitution of nucleophile in bimolecular fashion. Okay. So this is a mechanism name, SN1 and SN2. In SN1, it will be substitution of nucleophile, but unimolecular. That means only one molecule will be involved in the rate determining step. Okay. So this is what ether we, if you want to prepare, what we have to do. So before going further, let us summarize. Williamson synthesis is preparation of symmetrical and unsymmetrical ether. For that, you require two things, alkyl halide and sodium alkoxide, and they should be reacted in presence of dry ether. Okay. So let's see the further. I think up to here it is now clear. Before moving further, just have a glance and let's start with the next one. Okay, next one. This is the mechanism. Okay. So here, what is SN2, what is SN1, everything I am going to explain. So here, this is the sodium alkoxide. Okay. So in the sodium alkoxide, this is also substituted. Therefore, this will be 3 degree. Okay. So this will act as a nucleophile. Which file? Nucleophile. Okay. What is nucleophile? Everything is in the name only. Nucleo, nucleus, file means attracting. So why it is attracting nucleus? Because of the negative charge. So this negative charge wanted to attack on the carbon atom. So obviously carbon atom should have positive charge once it is having negative charge, and bromine will be negative charged. Okay. So here this nucleophile will come and attack on the methyl group. And this sodium is having plus charge. So sodium will go out with the negative bromine. So here we can see NaBr is removed and methyl group will be attached on the oxygen. This will be the product produced. Okay. So this is the final ether. And here we can see on the oxygen, both alkyl groups are entirely different. Here one methyl group and another is a tertiary butyl group. So this is called as an unsymmetrical ether. We can say it as a unsymmetrical ether. Okay. So this is how nucleophilic substitution takes place. Okay. What is being starting? That nucleophile, nucleus attracting. Why it is attracting? Negative charge. Okay. What it is attracting? Positive charge. And we are getting the unsymmetrical ether. Now I think it is clear with the mechanism. Okay, now let's start with the next page. Okay, better results. Okay, of the alkyl halide is primary. Okay, so here I will tell you one more condition. So the same thing we will expect. We will expect this type of reactant pair also. Okay. Here I will write it as a CH3, CCH3 and CH3. If I write, suppose here chlorine or bromine, okay? And I can take CH3ONa here. So that time also you can get this minus will be substituted over here and Na should be removed over here. And the same product we should expect, okay? But for results, we will represent as RX. RX degree must be less. Okay. So this circle means what it is degree. Okay. So then degree must be less. Okay. So once less degree is there, that time alkyl halide will be giving the good yield. Okay. And this is sodium alkoxide. Okay. So this is represented as R-ONa. Okay. So here this degree should be more, okay? So then it will be more and more productive and major product will be produced, okay? So for the better yield, okay? For the better yield, you should select the reagents, okay? In the NCERT only, there are questions based upon this sentence, okay? For better yield, alkyl halide must be 1 degree or primary. And for better yield, sodium alkoxide must be 3 degree or secondary. Then our product will be the best and fastest product. Okay. So I think it is clear now. Okay, now this is what it is written here. Better results are obtained when alkyl halide is primary. That means degree is less. Okay, so primary means it will be 1 degree. In case of the secondary, secondary means 2 degree, tertiary means 3 degree. Alkyl halide elimination competes. If you are trying in the other way, what will happen instead of substitution? What we want? Substitution of nucleophile we want. But what the reaction will takes place? Elimination will takes place. Okay? That example also I am taking here. If a tertiary alkyl halide is used, okay? Alkene is the only reaction product and no ether is formed. See, here what is the degree here? This is the carbon on which bromine is attached. On this 1, 2, 3 alkyl groups are attached on our targeted carbon atom. So, 3 alkyl group, therefore it will be 3 degree. And this is the carbon on which our ONA is attached. So, this will be 1 degree. So, we just reverse this sequence. Okay. I will show you the reactants are same, but just it is interchanged. Okay. See here. See here. 1 degree alkyl halide was there. 3 degree sodium alkoxide is there. Now, but presently we have 1 degree. Presently we have what? 1 degree alkyl halide and 3 degree haloalkane. That time, what we are getting? We are getting the alkene. What we are getting the? We are getting the alkene. Okay, not ether. So this is because alkoxide not only nucleophile but also strong bases. Okay, so this is a best MCQ. Okay. This is best MCQ for the most of the board exams, NEET exams and mains exams. Okay. So they will react with alkyl halide leading to the elimination. Okay. So here we are using nucleophile. So they are not only nucleophile. They will cause the elimination reaction also because they are bases. Because what? They are bases. Okay. Now I think it is clear now. Okay, next, phenols are also converted to ethers by this method. Already we have taken the two conditions, symmetrical ether and unsymmetrical ether. Okay, so ethers are further classified into aryl ethers also. Okay, so aryl ether, symmetrical ether, aryl ether and symmetrical ether. And next one will be unsymmetrical ether. Okay. In unsymmetrical ethers, only the major problem comes. What we will try to make R dash X, if it is haloalkane, then degree must be minimum. Okay. Degree of RX must be minimum. Degree of RX must be minimum. And degree of R dash ONA, this R dash degree should be maximum. Degree should be what? Maximum. Understood? Now, if you wanted to prepare the aryl ether, symmetrical ether, no problem. Both are same. You can take it anyway. So, phenols only the problem. By this method, in this phenol used as a phenoxide moiety. Okay. So, here the main problem with this is there will be double bond character, PDC, partial double bond character. Okay. So in that partial double bond character, what happens? This hydrogen will be replaced by sodium. Okay. So hydrogen will come over here and sodium will go over here. Okay. Then it will form as a sodium phenoxide. What it will form? Sodium phenoxide. Okay. Sodium phenoxide. Then we will use the RX. Okay. So then it will form the ether. Okay, but there is one alkyl group, therefore it is called as a aryl ether. Okay, and most famous and most useful ethers are when it is OCH3, then it is called as an anisole. What it is called as? Anisole. Okay, so this is most important named and commercially used ether, aryl ether. Okay, so I think it is clear now. Now let us see the next part. Then, as I told you, there are two reactions very important: Williamson synthesis. Basically, Williamson synthesis used for the preparation of ethers by using the haloalkanes with HI or HX. Okay. Now we are going to study. We are going in the ethers. What we are going to use? We are going to use the RX plus RONa, sodium alkoxide. Now the properties. Anyhow, we are able to prepare with the help of the Williamson synthesis. Now we are studying about the how they are going to react with the halogen acid. Okay, so halogen acid means HX. Here X can be fluorine, chlorine, bromine, and iodine. Okay, so but our reactant will be ROR. So there will be ROR means this will be carbon and oxygen bond. So this bond will break. Okay, so the ethers are the least reactive functional groups. Okay, so that's why they are treated as a prefixes only. During the naming also, what we will do, we will write the ethers as a prefix: methoxy butane, ethoxy propane, okay, ethoxy benzene. So ethoxy coming before, that means it is prefix. Okay, then cleavage of the CO bond in ether takes place under drastic conditions only, that too with excess of hydrogen halides. Okay, then what it will give? They will give you the dialkyl ether will give you the 2 alkyl halide molecule. See, there will give you the, if we are using the excess, then they are going to give you 2 alkyl halide molecule. Okay, see here, first one it is converted. Otherwise I will tell you the ninja technique. What technique? Ninja technique. Okay, so in the ninja technique we will write it like this: ROR. Okay, so this is 1HX. Array ninja technique failed. So 1HX here. Array. This is 1HX, this is another HX. Okay, so just like a ninja, you should cut it down. Okay, now I will cut with the different color. See, there will be cutting like this, there will be cutting like this. So what will be the product? RX and H2O. Okay, see here, the magic H2O is here, RX is here, RX is here. So 2 moles of RX plus 1 mole of H2O. That is what ninja technique. I think all of you like this ninja technique. So many ninja techniques I will be keep on giving you in my future classes also. Okay, so try to concentrate till the last. Now let's see the next one. Okay, next, alkyl aryl ether. So that was only alkyl ether, both side it was alkyl group. Okay, now here one side alkyl, one side aryl, that's why it is called as a alkyl aryl ether, are cleaved in the alkyl oxygen bond. So they will never and ever break this bond, they will always break this bond only due to the more stable aryl oxygen bond. Okay, this bond is more and more stable. This bond is what? More stable. So because of the more stability, they will always try to break from here only. Okay, so this R will come over here and H will go and attach here. So what will be the product? This is called as a phenol. Okay, so this always react and gives you the phenol only. Bond will never break between the benzene and oxygen. Okay, this bond will never break, this bond will always break. Okay, this bond will break, this bond will not break. Therefore phenol is must. Any ether containing one benzene ring will break the bond between the oxygen and alkyl group only. Okay, this is just like a memory trick. Okay, now if they are alkyl ether only, but they are of the different. Okay, so here this is unsymmetrical ether, also cleaved in the same manner. Then see here, one will be RX, another will be R dash OH. The order of reactivity of hydrogen halide, HBr greater than HBr greater than HCl. Actually, what happens in place of the HI, the hydrogen will be here and iodine will be here. Okay. So bond length is large and large enough. Okay. So therefore, bond energy will be least and least. Therefore, more reactive. Therefore, what? More reactive. Okay. So then HBr, HCl, that bond length will keep on decreases, bond energy will increase, therefore rate of reaction will automatically decreases. Okay. The cleavage of ether takes place with concentrated HI or HBr at high temperatures. Okay. So this is about the part. Okay. Okay, now here the mechanism, this mechanism reaction of the halogen acid with ether. Okay, that I am going to explain with the complete step-by-step mechanism. Okay, so you need not to by heart this. It should be habituated to write. You should be habituated to write the mechanism because all mechanism are same. Okay, so here see, if you know the reason, then automatically you will understand the mechanism. Here, because of this lone pair, it will be nucleophile. Lone pair, because of that, it will attract what? Nucleus. Therefore, it will act as a nucleophile. Okay. Now, this hydrogen is positive and iodine is negative. So, because of this negative nature will be there. So, that negative nature and hydrogen don't have electron. So, it will go and attach itself here. Okay. So why H plus is going and why it is going at this place, I think it is clear. Hydrogen don't have electron at all and this is having lone pair. So at that place go and attaches itself. Okay. So the reaction of an ether, this is ether with concentrated HI starts with protonation of ether molecule. Actually here H plus is called as a proton. Okay. Because hydrogen will contain one proton, one electron. So, but electron is not there because of the positive charge. So, it is left over with only proton. That's why it is called as a proton. Okay. And proton is added. That's why it is called as a protonation of the ether molecule. Now, if you understand one mechanism, slowly you will be able to write your own mechanism. Okay. Now, the reaction takes place with HBr or HI because these reagents are sufficiently acidic because already I told you because of the high bond length, bond energy is weak. Therefore, they are ready to lose the H plus. Okay. That means they are sufficiently acid. HCl, why it will not react? Because bond length is too short. It cannot lose the H plus. And HF is very, very problematic because bond length is very small. Okay. Now, iodine is a good nucleophile. So it will leave the H plus to that. But after that, it will not leave its alone. Okay. So see, first it gave that H plus to the oxygen. Then it started attacking on the methyl group. Okay. So then what it will do, it see how technically, how tricky person he is. Okay. He given them small hydrogen. Okay. But what he have taken? He have taken a big methyl group. Initially, this person, iodine, used to be with the small hydrogen. But after this reaction, now it is with the big methyl group. Okay, this is what the tricks. Okay, these are called as a business tricks. Initially, this ether will think iodine is very helpful nature. He is giving his H plus. But after that, they will come to know there it is taking the methyl group also. Okay. So what is the final product we are getting? We are getting the final product of alcohol and we are getting the product of iodoalkane. We are getting the final product of iodoalkane. So this is the mechanism and there are some special condition also that we are going to discuss now. Okay. These two steps are more than sufficient. But still, I will try to mention the special case mechanism. Okay. So what is that special case here? When HI is in excess and the reaction is carried out at a high temperature, ethanol react with another molecule of HI and converted to ethyl iodide. See, there is no alcohol here. We are getting the ethanol only two times. How many times we are getting? Two times we are getting the 2 moles of ethanol. But it will take place when? See, this was alcohol produced. Okay. So I will try to show you previous slide. So in this one, we already we have seen. See, here I will try to write. Okay. This methyl iodide is there, but this ether is alcohol is also being converted into the next step. Being converted into what? Again, ether alkyl halide only. Okay, so the total summary of the reaction I will write it here. Okay, so suppose ROR dash plus HI, and in bracket they will write excess. Don't worry, people are very good. They will write excess. So then both will be RI and R dash I. Okay. Plus H2O will be the common product when excess is written. Okay. Once excess is not written, then it will be one alcohol. Okay. HI is there. That time what it is going to give you? This was previous. Then if it is excess is not written, then one part will be alcohol, another part will be alkyl iodide. Another part will be what? Alkyl iodide. Okay. Another part will be what? Alkyl iodide. So this is the main product it is produced. Okay. Now, however, there is another special condition. This is one special condition, and second special condition is that when one of the alkyl group is tertiary, see here, this is what tertiary alkyl group. Tertiary, already I told you, this carbon is containing 1, 2, 3. So 1, 2, 3. So 3 alkyl groups are there. Therefore, it is called as a tertiary. Then alkyl halide formed is always tertiary halide. Okay. So this halogen automatically goes to 3 degree only. And small hydrogen goes to small group. Like this, you will remember another ninja technique. Okay. Ninja technique is that small hydrogen to the small alkyl group, it will go. Okay. Small alkyl group. Okay. Here, what is a small C? Here it is so big. And hydrogen is afraid of going to the alkyl group. Okay. Obviously, this will go to the small hydrogen, will go to the small alkyl group. Okay. So I think this will be helpful to you during the solving of the objective and writing the theory in the board exam. Okay. So it is because in the step two of the reaction, departure of the leaving group creates more stable carbocation. So if bond breaks here, there is a reaction stability 3 degree greater than, 2 degree greater than, 1 degree. So it is giving the 3 degree carbocation. Therefore, it is SN1 mechanism, substitution of nucleophile and unimolecular. I think it is clear now. Okay. So two ninja techniques we have learned in this class, and I hope all of you liked it. Okay. Now this is the summary. This is the summary I am going to give. So here, this is a protonated ether. This hydrogen came from the HI only. Okay. HI, this hydrogen came. And first, protonated, and it will give you the carbocation. Carbocation is what? 3 degree carbocation. Now the iodine is left over. Out of this, we have used only H plus. Now iodine is left. Iodine is very furious, very fast and furious to attack on the carbocation, which is 3 degree. So ultimately what we are getting here, we are getting the 3 degree alkyl halide and 1 degree alcohol. Small alcohol, huge alkyl iodide will be the product produced. Okay. Now I think it is clear. Now let's see the some more conditions. Lot of special cases there. Okay. Special case number 3. Okay. What is that? In case of the anisole, anisoles and phenytoin, both are very important. Anisole, already I have told you, anisole is simply on the benzene ring. If it is OCH3 is there, then it is called as anisole. Okay. Then methyl phenyl oxonium ion. See, this is phenyl. This is methyl oxonium ion is formed by protonation of the ether. Protonation. Then the main problem comes. The bond between OCH3 is weaker than the bond between OC6H5. Therefore, sp2 hybridize. Therefore, attack by the ion breaks on OCH3 bond to form CH3I. So here, what will be the form? This will be the iodine. Okay, here big iodine. Okay, big iodine react with the small alkyl group. Okay, small alkyl group. Okay, this is a when it should be benzene ring must be there. So benzene ring must be there. Always you will get the phenol. Okay, ether if it is available like this, then it like to form the phenol. Phenol is the most stable carbocation. Okay, so phenol is the most stable aromatic substance. Now let's see the next one. Electrophilic substitution. This already I told you, it will be there in every chapter. Friedel-Crafts reactions. Three types of Friedel-Crafts reactions are there. What are the three types of Friedel-Crafts reactions? Yes, Friedel-Crafts alkylation, Friedel-Crafts halogenation, and Friedel-Crafts acylation. Okay, so first we are going to study the Friedel-Crafts alkylation. What we are going to study? Friedel-Crafts alkylation. Okay, so before that, mechanism you should know. Okay, so here this lone pair is there. This is called as a head element. What it is called as? Head element. Okay, so head element will donate lone pair. So this position is called as, this position is called as, this position is called as, this position is called as. Already in my previous lectures also I told you, When you have to remember. Okay, so there are three positions. Already I told you the best ninja technique in the world. Okay, so this is the group one. This is called as a ortho. This is called as a meta. And this is called as a para. Okay, so Om Parameshwara. What I told you, Om Parameshwara is the ninja technique. Okay. Ninja technique. Okay. So in organic, we will know the ninja techniques. In physical, we will have the Doraemon's gadget. Okay. So with the gadget, you can understand. We can solve the numerical very fast. Okay. So Om Parameshwara. So this is ortho. So in the ortho, you can find it here. Negative charge is there. In the second place, see here, para position, negative charge is there. Again, this is which position? Again, this is also ortho position. So you will get electron in the ethers only at ortho and para. See, in the meta, no electron, meta, no electron, meta, no electron, meta, no electron. So the things will come up, okay? The things will come up only at the ortho and para position only, okay? The things will come up where? Only at the ortho and para position only, okay? I think it is clear now, okay? So this mechanism is very, very important. This mechanism is very important. So try to understand it nicely. Okay, now I think it is clear. So this ninja technique, don't forget, Om Parameshwara. Okay, now let's see the next part. I am erasing this. So next part is halogenation. In all the three reactions, this will be the common. Okay, so this will be the common. What is that? Substitution will take place at ortho position and para position. Okay, ortho position and para position. See here. halogenation will takes place. Here which position it is? Para position. Here which position it is? Ortho position. So para isomer is 90% yield. Okay. So nowadays everybody wanted to stay away, stay alone. Okay. So that same tendency came in the organic compound also. Why this product is very less? Only 10%. Okay. Suppose you by mistake you are selected as a AIIMS doctor. Okay, if you are writing with the NEET exam, you got selection in the AIIMS, or you are selected in the IIT if you are writing the BTech. Okay, so in the counseling they will ask, suppose you are from Hyderabad, okay, they will ask, will you join IIIT Hyderabad or AIIMS nearby Hyderabad? Then you will say, no, I don't want to stay with my parents, I wanted to go to the Delhi or Bombay. Okay, so same problem with the bromine also. Bromine don't want to stay congested with the methyl, this alkyl group. Okay, so that's why major of the students are asking for BTech in Bombay, AIIMS in New Delhi. Okay, so but they will take the name because AIIMS is best in the Delhi, AIIMS is best, or they will say mechanical engineering in the IIT is topmost. So, but they will get the benefit of staying away from the parents and doing all enjoyments. Okay. So, always the product at the para position is more stable. Okay. That's why that will be the major product. Okay. So, here bromine is substituted. Bromine is substituted here and bromine is substituted here. So, this is halogenation. Okay. Now, let's see the next one. After the halogenation, what we are going to study? Every time it is same, Friedel-Crafts alkylation. Okay, what is this? Friedel-Crafts alkylation. Okay, so in the Friedel-Crafts alkylation, everything, chemistry is the most genuine subject in the world. It's whatever it says, the same thing will be there. Friedel-Crafts alkylation. So alkyl group will be going and attached. Okay, and where attached? Already I told in the mechanism. At ortho position and at para position. See, this is ortho position, this is para position. Okay, so but among the ortho and para, which is more stable? The technique also I told you to remember, people wanted to stay away from the parents. Same way, people wanted to stay away, groups wanted to stay away from the, stay away from what? Alkyl group. That's why para product will be major product. Para product will be major product. Okay. I think it is clear now. Now let's go on to the next part. Okay. Let me clear it, save it and clear it. Then let's go for the next one. Okay. Now here it is the acylation. Friedel-Crafts acylation. This is called as a acyl. Acyl means acid halide. Okay, so same thing will happen. Acyl group at the ortho position, acyl group at the para position. Para position product will be the major product. Okay, so I think it is clear now. All of you understood it nicely. Okay, so then what you will do? This is the nitration. Okay, Friedel-Crafts alkylation, acylation, halogenation, then nitration. So nitration means it will be NO2 group will be substituted. Okay. So here that also NO2. All people will write HNO3 like this. Okay. So but being you are the legends. Okay. So legends will write HNO3 like this. All will write HNO3 like this. But you will write HNO3 like this. OH and NO2. Okay. So sulfuric acid is the most thrusty compound in the world. So what it will do? It will bring the hydrogen from the benzene ring and bring the OH from the nitric acid. Ultimately, what it is going to gain? It is going to get the water. Okay. Okay. So here H and OH, H and OH. Okay. So NO2 will be substituted. NO2 will be substituted here. And NO2 will be substituted here. So this is the major product and minor product. I think it is clear now. Okay. So let's see the next one. This is the summary you will make. Okay. So I think all of you will write it and get the highest marks with the single page notes. Name of the reaction, Friedel-Crafts reaction, reactant what it is, reagent what it is, product what it is. I hope all of you enjoyed the session. Thank you.